White Rider of the Four Horsemen. I have been summoned here from another place and time. To defeat the Four Horsemen is to open the door to the future. Those were his words. As it stands, the time has come to prove yourself. I wonder, are you truly capable of defeating us? Come, cast your fear to the wind. White Rider shall reveal the truth.
Witness my power! This'll do. Watch this.
Fiend, White Rider. Status eliminated. He spoke of proving yourself. Does that mean we are expected to defeat the other three? So he carried the menorah of compassion. I felt nothing of the sort coming from him. Or perhaps compassion in this case was his refusal to hold anything back.
Thank you.
world once knew a king. Mighty and formidable, he reigned over war and death. But in the end, even he was felled by the hands of those who sought his throne. And so that world collapsed, left to burn to oblivion. I bore witness to those final moments in time. I know not what sort of future you wish to forge, but if you desire a new world, then you will have to best me in combat. Hailing from the dark, I am Red Rider!
You ready?
Fiend, Red Rider. Status eliminated. That's two of the four horsemen now. To think they called themselves the Harbingers of Death. Though, to be fair, all of these fiends have been surrounded by the smell of blood. I wonder if the same can be said of us.
Protector of the menorah, one of the four horsemen, Black Rider. Here, I will test thy strength, but be warned, those lacking will fall. The world is beyond their reach. Now, show me thy power, bear thy very soul.
This will help.
Witness my power!
Here. Watch this. This will help.
Fiend, Black Rider. Status eliminated. And that's the third of the horsemen. That leaves just one. What will become of us once we've defeated all four?
And look who's here! Looking... Say, thanks!
Need any?
Perchance bring more?
Fallen. I suppose I should commend your performance. I believe I am beginning to see just what it is he saw in you. Perhaps you will succeed, after all. Or perhaps your victories thus far were not born of strength, but of luck. Allow me to find out for myself!
Thank you.
This'll do. This'll do.
here.
Fiend Pale Rider. Status eliminated. Finally, the fourth horseman falls. I believe we'll be able to rest easy for the time being. But was it because of our strength that we emerged victorious, or were we simply lucky? What do you think? If I may, I'd say it was a combination of the two. You undoubtedly possess the strength to have won the battles we've fought thus far, and fortune is clearly on my side. I met you, after all. I must say I'm grateful to the voice that woke me from my sleep and sent me your way. Truly.
Yes.
Yeah.
I will smite the unholy!
Look! Say thanks! Look! Say thanks! Look at... Say thanks!
Need anything?
See you around!
Thank you.
So the Demon King is dead, then. You're a credit to Bethel, Japan. That was no small feat.
Yeah, Master Abdiel said that too. So, did we save Tokyo? Is the world safe now?
No. I'd say the true battle is about to begin.
What? What do you mean?
I said it before. The real Tokyo is long gone. This Tokyo is a sacred simulacrum, restored by the power of God. But its time is running out. The world is fracturing, collapsing. If this demonic conqueror in Algami's report really did kill the Creator, all his divine miracles must be waning. Slaying the Demon King did much to protect the world at large, but Tokyo itself is now on the brink of destruction.
What?
So, our course is clear. As of today, I will be declaring my independence from Bethel.
You're leaving them?
If we want to save Tokyo, we have only one option left. To take the throne of Anahobino and craft a new world. But Bethel HQ remains doggedly opposed to this, which makes them our enemy, I'm afraid.
So heresy is our only option left. World creation has been forbidden, but...
You're just ditching Bethel?
To take the throne is to deny the Creator's will, and deny the laws he created. And to betray those laws is to betray Bethel itself.
But Master Abdiel was good to me. I'm nobody special, but she still helped me. Why do we gotta betray them like this? We could just ask them to help us save Tokyo, right?
Tokyo's faced apocalyptic destruction before, but the Archangel dismissed us, said it was destiny. And a Bethel, bereft of God, has even less stake in our future.
But we're just humans, ordinary people. How can we go against the angels?
Quite easily, with my help. I am their equal in power. No. I am an even higher being.
What? What are you saying?
I suppose you three deserve to know. The truth is, I am no human. I am Tsukuyomi of the Amatsukami, one of Japan's eldest guardians.
What?
Bethel's cooperation did help us protect Japan, and I am grateful to God for saving Tokyo. However, with the Creator dead, we are no longer bound to Bethel's will. Instead, we will fight to protect our home, even if they refuse to.
So the truth comes out.
I'll cut to the chase. Sometime soon, Bethel HQ is going to hold a summit, a meeting between all international branches. I would have you three accompany me.
What? Us? Seriously?
I expect many other branches in attendance, and depending on how the discussions go, things may escalate violently. However, Bethel Japan's lost most of its regular fighting force, casualties of Armageddon. As such, you three will be attending as my bodyguards. Security detail, at least on paper.
Understood.
When the dates are set, I will contact you. Until then, your time is yours to spend. Listen closely.
Hey, man!
Do you have a sec? It seems you've noticed as well.
How could this be? Tokyo is vanishing?
The Shekinah glory is unraveling. Tokyo was actually destroyed once, almost 2 decades ago. But God copied it back into existence, preventing any further anarchy. That was God's greatest modern miracle. The Shekinah glory. However, with God defeated, that miracle has begun to dissipate. Along with the city that depended on it. If we don't act fast, Tokyo might disappear forever.
Incoming message from Bethel, Japan. Tomorrow, a pandemonic summit will be held with all of Bethel's leadership. The summit will be held in the Netherworld. We are to await further orders at the Tokyo Diet Building.
Thank you.
Well, are you... It's shaping up to be a rather intense meeting, considering that the Japan Division intends to break away from Bethel. Every country will be represented at the summit, so this is sure to cause quite a stir among many. Be sure to exercise caution throughout. Just remember not to fret. No matter what happens, I shall protect you. After all, we will be attending a pandemonic summit. Nigh anything can happen during such an event. I do not tell you this to cause concern, though. I merely recognize that you were dragged into this situation and that you deserve a full understanding of it. I wish to see you rise against any obstacle in your path and use the circumstances to your advantage. It will be crucial to your survival.
Yes.
Do you mind?
Pardon me. This way.
Good. You're here. Time for that security detail. Let's go, you two.
Ah, if it isn't the champion of the Arioch campaign himself. We surely could not have triumphed without your strength.
You do me too much honor, Master Abdiel. I can only express my pride that the Japanese branch managed to serve Bethel's aims.
Indeed so. A duty I am sure you will continue to perform.
Of course.
I will go on ahead to the conference hall. Ensure you are not late.
I can already tell this is going to be a mess. Well, that means we're up. Please direct Yuzuru and his friend when they arrive.
Sir.
Greetings. I, Khonsu, represent Bethel, Egypt. Pleased to make your acquaintance.
I speak for the Greeks.
And I, the Nordic branch. I shall be filling in as Lord Shiva's proxy.
What, the Lord of Dance tire himself out?
Lord Shiva simply refuses to sit in with the rest of you. Now, let's begin with this pandemonic nonsense and be done with it. Abdiel?
Yeah.
Very well. As many of you are surely aware, we have recently achieved a decisive victory over the Legions of Chaos. Surt, Ishtar, Arioch. Each of them were formidable in their own right, yet all lie slain at the feet of Bethel, Japan. Henceforth, all forces that marched into the Netherworld may retreat and return to their normal duties.
I am unconcerned with the fate of Lucifer Strauss. What interests me is the Lord of Chaos himself. Word is he took out the Creator. Tell me what you make of that.
Clearly that falsehood was designed to lead us astray. Do not be deceived. Bethel must remain united.
How dim are you? You realize with the Creator gone, we might as well drop the pretense of an alliance altogether.
True. I see no merit in joining forces any further. Lord Shiver has in fact expected this, and is already preparing our next move. Patience, everyone. Perhaps it would do us all well to step back and review our circumstances.
Khonsu speaks wisely. Rather than acting rashly, let us each take a moment to reason amongst ourselves.
This is a good opportunity to discern where each faction stands. Go and listen to what each of them has to say.
See for yourself the Creator's almighty handiwork. See how the Earth's inhabitants lament their injustices and buckle under misfortune. Had we the authority, we would create a world of gladness, where all are treated with equity and compassion.
Dead, his throne ought to be free for the taking. At least that's how it should work. I'm sick of hearing babble from that winged wench and her automatons.
Long ago, the Creator, in his boundless arrogance, issued an edict of condemnation, damning all gods to primitivity. This condemnation forbade the existence of Nahobino outright, thus preventing any challenge to his reign. Oh, how I long to break free of this curse. But wait, are you not a Nahobino? How could you have broken the shackles that bind us? A time of great undoing is upon us. The word of Lord Shiver has been spoken. I must say, this world of flaws and contradictions fashioned by an absentee ruler is long overdue for renovation.
I've always aspired to keep our city safe. To me, working with Director Koshimizu seems the most logical way to accomplish that. And now, with everything that's happened, it's clear to me that one almighty being isn't enough to protect Tokyo. Not by a long shot. That's why I want the world to be as the Director envisions. Where the gods of old watch over us, governing with their wisdom.
I'm Japanese too, so I'm all for the idea of protecting Japan. Still, Master Abdiel's words make the most sense to me.
18 years ago, Tokyo endured the conception unwittingly. Now, with the Shekinah glory fading, the loss we face would be unbearable. We were wrong to place our trust in one god. Only a multitude of divine beings can give the world the proper attention it needs. Furthermore, it is only right for us, the Amatsukami, to keep our land secure.
The Creator can never be defeated. But were that even to be true, surely he would rise up once more. Yes, we must await his glorious return. Until then, we join hands and guide our people. That is Bethel's duty. Hear me. Bethel's mission is to sustain this world, God's world. Any objections?
Damn right there are. I say you cut the act and admit your god is dead and gone.
He speaks true. Besides, Lord Shiva will soon bring this world to its proper end. On whose authority? If any being is to decide this world's fate, it will be me.
Not while the condemnation stands, it won't. It is undeniable proof that the Most High still sits upon the throne.
Does he? Then how do you explain the Nahobino standing here before us? Are we to take it this god of yours deems him a worthy successor to the throne? Forgive me, but is he not the proto-fiend of Bethel? Has your god not chosen him?
Very well. If his existence serves as blasphemy, I cannot remain in ignorance. Witness, as I smite this aberration and blot out his sin from the earth.
judgment!
Thank you.
You ready?
Impossible. How could I have fallen?
So this is the power meant for us. Not bad now, Bino. God was right to be afraid. Perhaps I, too, will seek out my old knowledge. And so were our ties to Bethel severed. When we next meet, it shall be as adversaries. May none be so foolish as to cross me.
I must inform Lord Shiver of this new development.
Well, I'm done.
All have forsaken us for their own selfish gain. Does this please you, Tsukuyomi? To see demonkind fall to chaos? To see all that Bethel has struggled for scattered?
I truly couldn't be more satisfied. Entrusting this beautiful world to such a vain despot was always a mistake. We shall establish a new world order. One where countless gods can freely illumine the horizon. As for you, Abdiel, may you find your home. By the way,
owns it. Correct.
Ah! Crystal, sidetrack! Arrow!
Thank you.
eliminated.
Correct. Yes.